Are Ben and Missy late?
Oh no, they're here.
They went to the bathroom.
20 minutes ago. What?
Yes.
Do they have sex like all the time?
Hey!
Hey! I ran into a couple of his friends.
Line.
Who'd you run into?
Yeah.
Dave and Barbara.
In the bathroom?
The movie is about a group of friends who have families and get a bit distant. And I've read that your friend and co-star Adam Scott has admitted to being busy once he's started a family.
Yes.
Is this story kind of based on him or?
No, not at all. I mean, it's based on really just observing so many people in our lives, you know, make the transition to parenthood, which is obviously such a profound and game-changing transition. And it's an interesting thing to sort of be out of sync with your peer group, watching them go through this and sort of being a part of their lives and their children's lives, but also being on the outside of it a little bit and suddenly losing your friends in a way when they're really, really stressed and missing that one-on-one time with them and watching just how they handle becoming parents. It's sort of different for everyone, and I think it was interesting for me to observe it and also be somewhat a part of it in terms of what my friends were undergoing.
When we met, you were in your 20s.
So?
So, 28, 22, that's hot. 38, 32, not so much. I'm kidding!
Why don't we just do it?
What?
We really want to have a kid, so share all the responsibility and just skip over the whole marriage thing.
Can't really tell if you're kidding right now.
You've written the screenplay, you've produced it, you've directed it.
Well, I was one of many producers, I'll say. There were about six of us.
And you've, you know, directed it. How do you juggle so many things and make such a great
movie? I don't
know,
it was probably a terrible idea. I don't know. Honestly, we were looking at other directors and I had never intended to direct it. Jake Kasdan was going to direct it and his schedule was complicated with Bad Teacher post, so that kept kind of going on and on. And with every indie film, you know, there's this moment where it starts to become real, where you can find that lucky 4 weeks where everybody's available. And that happened on this one, and the only way to make it and keep our cast was for me to step into the director's role. So I took that on, and luckily Jake was there on set every day to sort of have my back as a producer and as a collaborator, and my DP, Will Rexer, was amazing and really helped me with the unbelievably steep learning curve of this. So I think without kind of a great support system in place on set, it wouldn't have been possible, but I guess it became barely possible.
May I approach the bench?
Oh!
Oh my God! We've always wanted you guys to get together.
Oh no!
No.
You're not getting together. You're just going to do it one time and have a kid.
Yes.
Totally makes sense to me.
Oh my God, that is the worst idea I ever heard.
Oh my God! So exciting!
It's coming!
I feel like it's coming out of my
So it's your directorial debut?
Yes, it is.
And you directed yourself?
Yes.
And you directed your partner, John Hamm?
Yes.
What was more challenging, directing yourself or directing John?
Well, you know, it's funny, this was such an unbelievable cast. It's like the dream cast. I can't believe all these people wanted to do this small project. And so when you're dealing with actors of that caliber, it's not really about, you know, finding a performance whole cloth. It's more about finding the nuances and making sure we have enough options in the editing room. So it's really just about try it a little more this way, a little less that way. Let's do the opposite so we have that in the can and you know, shaping it. But they're all so amazing. It's not exactly a challenge.
And I mean, a lot of the cast are, you know, a lot of them are from Bridesmaids.
Yeah.
Was that kind of coincidence?
It was. I mean, what's funny is that Kristen was interested in doing this role before she even shot Bridesmaids, and I think mostly because it sort of gave her the opportunity to do something different than she's done before. And Chris O'Dowd, we met in the casting process. I took a meeting with him, and his agents were really keen on this role for him, and he's just a festival of charm.
He's literally
the most charming man you'll ever meet. So after I met him, it was very hard to imagine anyone else as Alex. And John, you know, John did a day and a half on Bridesmaids, so we didn't know if he would even end up in the movie.
Okay.
Because, you know, Judd Apatow sort of famously shoots hours and hours of film.
Yeah.
Excuse me. And, you know, you may or may not make it into the cut. It was really an uncredited cameo that became this bigger thing. So we didn't think too much about it at the time, and now it's this juggernaut, which is amazing.
Hey. Hey. Something smells good.
Hey, Jason made the most amazing quiches.
I don't think this is so hard.
This is clean, simple.
When do you think it'll be okay to get naked with someone?
Let me see. I think we're 3 weeks out.
Thanks.
This is it. You only get one shot of first impression.
Okay. Oh my gosh.
I am Kurt.
Wow. You are one extremely handsome German man.
I'm actually from Long Island, but how are you?
Sit.
Holy. Just go with this.
You're gonna hit on me with a baby? Boo.
I'm not married.
I think I met the girl today.
MJ?
I've heard so much about you. I have two of your thongs in my apartment. I wash them.
So you used Adam Scott as your partner in the movie.
Yes.
And then when, you know, was there any reason that you didn't use John, or was it because you didn't want him kissing Megan Fox?
Oh, no, it wasn't that. I mean, John was really drawn to this role of Ben, mm-hmm. and I think we both thought it was an interesting way to use him in this film, because he's just one of those amazing actors that can make darkness and pain so compelling. And he's also sort of the voice of the audience, I think, in this movie, even though he sort of doesn't say it in a nice way in that big climactic scene. He's really speaking the truth in the film. And so we both were drawn to that role for him. And Adam was just so right for this part, you know?
Yeah,
and the first day that I finished the draft of the film, we had actors over our house to read the script around our dining room table, and Adam came over and read the lead and crushed it. And after that moment, it was just really hard to picture anyone but Adam doing it. So I kind of campaigned hard for that from that moment forward.
Jason Jewell, not everyone thought that this little arrangement was going to work out.
So why didn't you guys ever even try being together?
It's too much familiarity. It's like she's one of my limbs.
And that's bad because...
It was talk. It might end in tears.
He's like a brother.
Oh, he's like an annoying dog of a brother.
Whose idea was this anyhow?
Oh, it was his.
Hers.
It was yours.
Good luck to you guys. I can't wait to see how it all turns out.